Across the U.S. today, outrage on the streets.
I cannot bear the fact that children are sleeping on concrete with aluminum foil as their cover.
The new images showing the dire conditions at migrant facilities came in a memo from the Department of Homeland Security's Inspector General, calling on the agency to take immediate steps to alleviate dangerous overcrowding and prolonged detention of children and adults. Border protection agents are on the defensive.
Because the entirety of the system is oversaturated, what is happening on the border itself is that we are having to, in CBP, to detain these people longer than these facilities were ever designed to do.
It's not just the facilities, but the culture of Border Patrol facing criticism. An investigation by journalists at ProPublica found a closed Facebook group filled with lewd and cruel posts allegedly written by border agents. Latina lawmakers who toured a migrant facility were called scumbuckets, hoes, and bitches. Another post questioned whether the heart-wrenching photo of a father and daughter from El Salvador who drowned was real, asking, "Have y'all ever seen floaters this clean?"
From what I can tell you, again, this is not representative of what the U.S. Border Patrol stands for.
This is the Texas facility toured by Democratic lawmakers. Women there claimed they didn't have medicine and had been separated from their children.
They put them in a room with no running water, and these women were being told by CBP officers to drink out of the toilet.
Border Protection says it's doing the best it can in the face of a growing crisis.
But that's not good enough for the people protesting across the United States, including here in front of the White House tonight. There's no sense, though, that President Trump is hearing them. He has not condemned the Facebook group's posts. Instead, he questioned migrants who claimed asylum, saying most are coming to the United States for purely economic reasons. Ellen Morrow, CBC News, Washington.